stand beside her and guide her through the night with a light from above, from the mountains to the prairies, to the oceans white with foam. Give peace, O Lord, to those who wait for you. Hear the prayers of your servants and guide us in the way of justice. Our opening hymn can be found at number 606, Glory and Praise to Our God, number 606.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Thank you for coming today. Not even formally in the bulletin, but great to see so many people here today offering prayers for our country. And we'll be taking the Mass for Peace and Social Justice, social in the correct sense of that term, social in the sense of a real concern for others, not in some kind of political machination, but rather just in the real concern for other people. And celebrating the 4th of July in this country, it really, if we look at the history, it's been like a 5,000-year leap where we really are called to be that people governed by truth, goodness, and beauty, natural law, all those wonderful things that the founders established. So we come to pray for our country, to pray for our world, to pray for our families, and the real reason why we come to Mass, to say thank you to God. Let us acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred and holy mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I've greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I've done and what I've failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Father of all nations and ages, we recall the day when our country claimed its place among the family of nations. For what has been achieved, we give you thanks. For the work that still remains, we ask your help. And as you have called us from many peoples to be one nation, grant that under your providence, our country may share your blessings and to all the peoples of the earth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing, as they rejoice before you as at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder and the rod of their taskmaster, you have smashed, as on the day of Midian. For every boot that trampled in battle, every cloak rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us, upon his shoulder dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful. From David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please turn to number 1203 for your responsorial psalm.
To his people.
chapters to read, sorry.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians.
Sorry.
Brothers and sisters, have no anxiety at all, but in everything, by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence, and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing what you have learned and received and heard and seen in me. Then the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. From the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked for where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst, and he said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. His disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and he said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
I think in our gospel today, we can take great consolation in the second reading from Paul to the Philippians, right? Have no anxiety at all. Boy, sounds simple, sounds good, doesn't it? But we look around at all the confusion, all the chaos, and we have to remind ourselves that, recall the story in Lot and Abraham's time, when God was saying, "If there's just a few good people, I'm going to watch out for you guys. So don't give up. Just be the few good people and have no anxiety at all. Because God will take care of everything." This country is really an anomaly in human history. It was really the first time when the people came together and chose to be governed by the principles of natural law. And I mean sound principles of natural law, sound principles that root itself in the great dignity of every single human being. And they recognize these natural rights, the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. And this reality is an amazing thing. And they held these truths to be self-evident. And in reality, they are. But what has happened in our world, it kind of a little complicated. People started to think, and they went from understanding truth in the true sense of that word. In Greek, the word is aletheia, which means truth is uncovered. In other words, it doesn't depend on me. And the church embraced this from Augustine on, and they started to realize that if we think well, it will only lead us to God. Think about this. If God created you and he's real and he gave you a brain and you use it well, it's only going to lead you to him. The problem is, if you don't use it well, it won't. And it's rife with pitfalls and confusion, all the rest. So society was going along just fine. And then there was a guy named Rene Descartes. And you may have heard this before, but the Latin is cogito ergo sum, which is, I think, therefore I am. All right? Which isn't as dumb as it sounds. He basically was trying to put everything out of his mind, and he realized that the brain was working, the cognitional processes were there, and he realized, I'm a thinking being. The problem came when people started to believe, I think, therefore it is. In other words, it's our perception, our belief is what makes something true. And that's not true. That's ridiculous. Many years ago, I was chaplain over at Bishop Luer's, and I would put a stapler on the desk, and I would say, okay, guys, I want everybody to think that that stapler is a pineapple. It's still a stapler. So I guess what you think doesn't matter. And yet our world has been drawn into this. That if I think I'm someone other than who God made me to be, it only harms us. God always forgives. Nature never forgives. And that's what's so amazing about our country, because it was built on these principles of natural law. And this great dignity. It was in a way, it was a 5,000 year leap, actually, where the people saw the government as something that was to serve them and not a government that would put its finger and thumb on people to serve the government. See, that's what's so amazing about our country. And I think, really, just a few people need to be as committed to these few crazy people that are out there, in a loving, charitable way, to recognize that what we have here is a great gift. And this freedom is a reality that we need to cherish and ask the Lord to help us realize what we have. I think it was Samuel Adams who said, for tyranny to thrive, you need two things. The people need to have the free rein of the vices. In other words, they can be immoral and seek their pleasures in a free way. And the other is ignorance. It's when there's vice and ignorance, tyranny can thrive. Kind of sad, but it seems like we're heading in that direction, right? And so the idea is, don't be filled with vice. Now, this is something that came to me, and I never really realized the connection until I was looking at it in Spanish. But what happens, what do we call the person who practices the virtues? We call that person virtuous. And a virtue is nothing less than just a good habit. If you practice good habits, you become virtuous. Now, what's the opposite of a good habit? A vice, right? What happens when you practice the vices? You become vicious, vicious. It's the same word. We become vicious. So what seems to mark our public discourse? Is it virtue? Or more, does it lean towards viciousness? We need to recapture virtue. And have no anxiety at all. Don't worry about someone else's virtue. Just do your best to practice yours. Because God will recognize and protect even just the few who keep their faith and trust in Jesus. Nations rise and fall. Christ doesn't. If we keep our hearts focused on Christ, nothing else matters. And indeed, as Paul says, we will have no anxiety at all. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Let us stand as we bring our prayers of intercession before the Lord. We pray for the church, that she may be a light to the nations and a guide to all peoples. We pray to the Lord. For all nations throughout the world, that they may know and serve the common good and not be motivated by greed and self-interest, we pray to the Lord. For more vocations to the priesthood, religious life, faith-filled marriages, and the dedicated single life, we pray to the Lord. For Patricia Presnell, the intention of this Mass, we pray to the Lord. For our country, and the principles that it's founded on in natural law, in the pursuit of truth, goodness, and beauty, we pray to the Lord. That all corruption in our world be uncovered, both in the church and outside her ranks, and those responsible for it lose their power or be converted, so that we can have leaders that respect life, religious liberty, and all that's in accord with natural law, we pray to the Lord. For safety on this 4th of July weekend, where many people are blowing things up and doing things that can be quite dangerous, that God protect them, we pray to the Lord. For Ukraine and those regions of the world that suffer under tyranny or incompetent rule, we pray to the Lord. And that all of us may respond to the grace God gives us to truly be filled with peace and long for his kingdom, without feeling the pressures of anxiety and stress that's all around us, we pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, hear the prayers of the people gathered here before you, those spoken and those kept in the silence of our hearts. Answer them insofar as they meet our deepest needs and are in accord with your holy and divine will. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. The offertory hymn can be found at number 828, Make Me a Channel of Your Peace. Number 828.
Blessed are
you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Father, who have molded into one our nation, drawn from the peoples of many lands, grant that as the grains of wheat become one bread, and the many grapes one cup of wine, so we may before all others be instruments of your peace, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. He spoke to us a message of peace and taught us to live as brothers and sisters. His message took the form in the vision of our founding fathers as they fashioned a nation where we might live as one. His message lives on in our midst as our task for today and a promise for tomorrow. And so with hearts full of love, we join the angels today and every day of our lives to sing your glory as we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy,
Lord God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you
therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Therese, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Kevin, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you've summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of God.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Communion hymn is number 909. Jesus, Hope of the World, number 909.
Let us pray. May the love we share in this Eucharist, Heavenly Father, flow in rich blessing throughout our land, and by your grace, may we as a nation place our trust in you and seek to do your will through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May God, the Father who has called us to be one human family, fill your hearts with deep longing for peace and harmony.
Amen.
May the Son of God, who came to share our life and make us children of the one Father, enable you to grow in wisdom and grace before God and the human family.
Amen.
And may the Holy Spirit, who is the bond of love between the Father and the Son, unite in love all here present. May he be the bond of love among you, our nation, and all people.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in this day of battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil.
May God rebuke
you.
Him,
we humbly pray. And to thou, Prince, the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan, all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking our souls. Amen. And let us ask Our Lady's intercession for peace in Ukraine and also peace in our nation and in our families. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Our closing hymn can be found at number 829, Let There Be Peace on Earth, number 829.
Let it begin with me.
Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be. With God as our Father, brothers all are we. Let me walk with my brother in perfect harmony. Let peace begin with me. Let this be the moment now. With every step I take, let this be my solemn vow, to take each other and live each moment in peace eternally. Let there be peace on earth, and let it be.
This is all going to go away.